What's your name, please?
Olivia.
How old are you, Olivia?
7.
Tell me what you're going to do for us today.
A poem.
A poem? Oh, wow. Can you tell me, what do you want to do when you're bigger?
What?
What do you want to be when you grow up?
A zoologist.
Oh. Amazing. Okay, when you're ready then, Olivia, you start.
Here she comes. You all right?
You said there was nothing in that box!
Oh my God, I hate snakes!
Oh my God!
Olivia!
Well, the Brit's gone silent!
Olivia! Goodness me, Olivia!
It's wrapped round her head.
Who is that?
Lucy.
Lucy's wrapped round her head.
Okay. Do you think you can do your poem now?
Yeah.
Great. Okay. When you're ready.
Come on. Don't you have a heart? You don't want these animals to depart. Forget the X Factor and the top 10 singing chart. Look at the most endangered animals and the poison dart. The Yama leopard, Siberian tiger, and polar bear. They're so gorgeous, it is just not bear. If I say their letter names, will you litter more? Oh, Louis, please don't say this is a bore.
Yeah, you tell that Louis Wolf with his snakeskin handbags. Louis.
Just haven't finished.
Rhymes Komodoensis. Komodo dragon, by the way. Why does man have to take them all away? Man, you're such a fool. Snake skin to lie for handbags? That is just not cool. Please listen to my passion. Although it may not be in fashion, I cannot sing it. You might laugh. I cannot dance. You'd say that I was daft. But I am 7, and I want these animals to last.
Hello. Welcome.
Thank you.
Actually reminds me of a Little Britain sketch that I did. Please, could I have your names?
I'm Paddy.
Yeah, I'm Nico.
And what is the nature of your relationship?
It's a professional one.
And might we ask you your age?
I will be 80 this July.
Do you think you can win the show?
Oh, it would be very nice, but just as long as people enjoy what we're doing and we give people pleasure, that's the main thing.
Okay, well, best of luck.
What? Shut up, man!
They're going straight through to the live shows.
Oh my God, I'm so proud of you. I just thought that was incredible. Well done.
Thank you.
Absolutely incredible.
Wow. Well, look, I apologise for what I did, because I did obviously buzz a little early. This is before all the crazy things happened, you know? It was all kind of like slow and normal, and then it all went ballistic. It was extraordinary.
You're an amazing example to older people, because you've shown that however old you are, you can still be spectacular and beautiful and do something amazing.
She can. All people can. If you want, you can.
How did you get into dancing?
I had been a dancer from the age of 2 and a half, like lots of little girls, and I gave it up to get married. I had 4 children.
Then when did you pick up dancing again?
I went to live in Spain with my husband, and unfortunately, after 18 months, he died. And for something to do, I went to Nico's Dance Academy to learn something totally different, and this is the result.
My grandmother is 93 years old, and I just kept thinking of her when you were being thrown around that man, and I think she would have wanted me to press my buzzer for you as well. So me and my nan are going to be right behind you, and I hope you win Britain's Got Talent. The fact that you did it for all those years and then had your lovely children, then lost your husband, you gave up so much.
Well, when I started to do this, I spoke with the family and I said, what do you think? And they said, well, you gave everything up to have us look after Dad, and he would be proud.
Yes, he would.
Paddy, you are my hero. Like, you are unbelievable. I pray to God that I am like you when I'm your age. I don't want to sound patronising, but we have to just say it as it is. That is something I've never seen before. I'm so pleased Amanda has pressed her button.
Go. And do you know what? We don't have to vote. And if you have a minute, I don't think
so.
What?
Expecting that.
No!
It was fantastic. Obviously unexpected, because you seem sort of a mild-mannered guy, you don't, you know. I mean, sorry, I didn't think, oh, here comes a rock god.
We'd love being surprised on this show. When the guitar came out, I thought, this isn't gonna go well, and you were actually brilliant.
Penny, I'm going to kick this off. A rocking yes from me.
It's a yes from me, Kenny.
It's a yes from me.
Well, Kenny, you've got 4 yeses.
Well done.
Right, what's your name, darling?
My name is Susan Boyle.
Okay, Susan, where are you from?
I am from Blackburn near Bathgate, West Lothian.
It's a big town.
It's a sort of collection of... It's a collection of, villages. I had to think there.
And how old are you, Susan?
I am 47. And that's just one side of me.
Hello. Okay, what's the dream?
I'm trying to be a professional singer.
And why hasn't it worked out so far, Susan?
I've never been given the chance before, but here's hoping it'll change.
Okay, and who would you like to be as successful as?
Elaine Page.
Elaine Page.
Like, what are you going to sing tonight?
I'm going to sing I Dreamed a Dream from Les Miserables.
Okay.
Big song.
Yeah? Yes.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by.
Susan Pierce.
Without a doubt, that was the biggest surprise I have had in 3 years on this show. When you stood there with that cheeky grin and said, I want to be like Elaine Page, everyone was laughing at you. No one is laughing now. That was stunning, an incredible performance. Amazing. I'm reeling from shock about you two, but
I am so thrilled because I know that everybody was against you. I honestly think that we were all being very cynical, and I think that's the biggest wake-up call ever. And I just want to say that it was a complete privilege listening to that. It was brilliant.
Susan, I knew the minute you walked out...
Oh, Simon!
On that stage, that we were going to hear something extraordinary, and I was right.
Not a lot of tosh.
Susan, you are a little tiger, aren't you?
Well, I don't know about that.
You are? I don't know about that. OK, moment of truth. Piers, yes or no?
The biggest yes I have ever given anybody.
Amanda?
Yes, definitely. Brilliant.
Amanda, you too!
Susan Boyle, you can go back to the village with your head held high. It's three yeses.
I think you enjoyed that just a little.
Wouldn't you have?
What a voice.
Incredible.
Congratulations.
Oh, my God.
Congratulations.
Oh, my God.
How do you feel?
Bloody fantastic.
Piers says that's the biggest yes he's ever given on the show. In three series.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Mind-blowing.
Most extraordinary shock we've ever had.
Just so emotional. Unbelievable and emotional. And fantastic.
Welcome.
Hi.
Hi. What's your name?
Geneviève.
What do you do?
I'm an entertainer. I like making noise.
Making noise. If you won this thing, would this change your life?
Oh, my God. I'm very grateful to be here. My boyfriend and my friend are in the audience. And it's a great opportunity, even if life is difficult sometimes. We can achieve the impossible if we believe in it.
Do you believe you can win this?
I believe.
Wow.
I believe. Make
us believe. Good luck, young lady.
Thank you. Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you.
You said you were a noisemaker, and I was like, what does that mean? Mon ami, you are more than a noisemaker. That was absolutely outstanding.
Thank you.
Wow.
She could absolutely revolutionize the whole music industry because she did the job of like 50 people. That was wild, no pun intended.
Yes. Did any of you think you would be cheering for something
what
like
do
that
you
today?
Think
like,
of
let's
this?
Be real. So different and so unique. But what do you call that? What is your job?
My job is an imitator, comic stand-up, and noisemaker. I wish one day I can do Gizmo and the.
What?
McGraw.
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 OMG. I was so excited to do this show because I have always had an issue with the fact that I was forced to leave Canada to go do what I wanted to do. My biggest dream is to find something that we haven't seen before. Something that will say, this is this person from Canada. This is a talent. And you know what? This is the moment that it happened for me.
Canada, and I know that it's great.
Champion! You are Howie's golden buzzer. How do you feel?
I feel happy. I don't know how I feel, my God.
Well, I'll tell you something. You made me so proud. This is the reason that I want to be on the show. You are the reason that I want to be on this show. I'm so excited. I cannot wait for the world to see you.
Hello.
Who are you?
We're Old Men Grooving.
Okay. Do you have jobs?
Yes, we do.
I'm an IT manager.
I'm a teacher. And I do some part-time teaching as well.
Do you think that this is something that the Queen or the Royal Family would like?
Yeah, we think they're going to love what we're doing.
Okay, best of luck.
Thank you.
Imagine being their kids.
I want dance, don't ask me. I want dance, don't ask me.
We'll be right back.
fantastic. Britain's Got Talent.
That's my favourite one.
The idea behind this is fantastic. Now, we do see a lot of dance acts, and you're by far one of the more memorable ones, and actually, you've come with something original. It was humorous, it was lively, it was entertaining, it was spot on.
Made dad dancing cool.
Hey! It was fantastic and it feels warm and I think everybody's going to absolutely love you at
definitely
home.
Definitely warm in his jumper.
Yeah, I was going to say, and really sexy brown shoes, boys.
I was not expecting that. I thought when the first song came on, I thought, oh God, this is going to be awful. But you tricked me. A lot of dance acts I get bored rigid by, but you lot I could watch all night. It just goes to show you, and I really mean this, that age is nothing but a number.
Yeah! We're gonna vote. David, yes or no?
I'm gonna say yes.
Alicia?
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
OMG. Four yeses.
What is your name?
My name is Sydney Abbott.
Sydney, how old are you?
10.
10 years old? Wow. And what do you do, Sydney?
I'm going to be dancing for you tonight.
Well, you are just so sweet and so small that I just absolutely wish you the best. Good luck.
Thank you so much. Bye.
Okay, goodbye.
If we're voting on cuteness.
Oh, my yes. goodness.
Does she not know that she was supposed to stay and perform?
Oh.
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 Excuse me.
Oh! What?
Wow.
Wow.
We are the mistress from the Philippines.
Mabuhay!
Mabuhay!
Thank you.
All right, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
To me when I need you.
I did not see that coming. I have to say that, you know, with your outfit and then the voice, you really got our attention.
And by the way, you in the middle, what's your name?
My name is Mariko.
What's your real name?
Joselito.
Okay.
You know what?
Boom, boom.
Sir David, yes. Aside from Joselito, Mamma Mia, what's your real name?
Romeo.
Conrado.
Anyway, let's vote. David.
I'm going to say yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Vanessa.
Yes.
Buddy, come on.
Yes.
Come on.
Sex bomb, sex bomb. Yes.
All right, yes. Oh.
Entertaining and so much fun. Yes. So three yeses and my yes too.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm 77 in June.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Have you had any work done? Because you look great.
No.
No. Wow. Someone in the room has not had work done. It's incredible. Chrissy, I'd just like you to take the stage.
Thank you. Thank you.
She's being all mysterious, isn't she?
Expecting that.
Wow. I've got nobody to talk to now.
Yes, with him. O secunde.
Ah, Manu dansează.
Slowly, moving up slowly.
E foarte bună direcția din punctul meu de vedere. Adică, bă, ai nevoie să te muți? Sună la doamna Cristina. Ai o pană la tractoraș? Sună la doamna Cristina. Ai pană la volă? Doamna Cristina. Eu nu vreau să-mi lăsați numărul de telefon pentru că...
Ai nevoie de o rochie cu franjuri? Sunt la Cristina.
Eu vreau să-mi lăsați numărul de telefon pentru că eu nu mai am prieteni care să-mi răspundă când e vorba de bătaie. Și eu m-aș baza pe dumneavoastră.
Pot să adaug faptul că sunt și polisportivă. Sunt ultramaratonist montan. Ciclist de anduranță brevetat la Odox în 2017, respectiv anul ăsta. Sunt practicant de kickboxing și taekwondo, am luat și trofee la 41 de ani.
Bravo.
Am trecut pe categoria de vârstă la campionatul național de Strong Woman și Strong Man. Am ieșit pe locul întâi la așa ceva.
Eu m-am reapucat foarte serios după ce am divorțat, după ce am băgat divorț și am fost evacuată copii în stradă. E greu și nu-i doresc nimănui, sub nicio formă în viața asta, să treacă prin tot ce am trecut eu. Cumva am stat câteva luni într-un centru maternal, unde de acolo mi-am construit din nou planurile și am luat-o din nou, de multe ori, de la sub zero. Adică în a face foamea la propriu, să tremure carnea pe tine, dar chiar dacă plângeam, am plâns foarte mult, nu am renunțat sub nicio formă. Decât să beau, decât să-mi nenorocesc zilele, m-am refugiat în sport. Stădeam câte 45 ore la sac în continuu, plângeam și dădeam.
Pentru Cristina, eșecul este un lux pe care nu și-l permite. Muncește de la vârsta de 14 ani și numeroase au fost modurile de a-și câștiga existența. Sportul a ajutat-o să se ridice de câte ori simțea că nu mai face față. Cu mentalitate de învingătoare, Cristina este ultramaratonist montan, ciclist de anduranță, practică box, jiu-jitsu și a fost de două ori campioană națională la K1.
Contează foarte mult că atunci când îți este greu, în orice situație dificilă, întotdeauna să vezi partea bună a lucrurilor, pentru că lucrurile aia se întâmplă cu un scop. în evoluția ta.
Bravo, doamna Cristina!
Mulțumesc frumos!
Andra?
Este foarte impresionant tot ce am văzut. Te admir și ești un exemplu pentru toate femeile, un exemplu de putere și de forță și de dorință de a realiza ceea ce îți dorești. Felicitări!
Mulțumesc frumos!
Doamna Cristina, aveți 4 de dat și ne vedem într-o etapă următoare.
Mulțumesc!